Here we are about to watch our video.
Tune in, folks.
Hey kids, here we are. It's about 1 a.m. and we're sitting in our pool sipping tequila sodas. And we are antisocial people. We have no friends. So we decided to kick back and watch our wedding footage. I hope you enjoy. And if you're wondering why we're sitting in a giant unicorn, I don't know why. Just sounded like a fun idea. I love this. I think we're the first people to have a drone shot go over the LA. I think we're the first people to have a drone go over the Bellas Hotel for this.
Just 4 months into our relationship, because I knew already then that you were the one. Here's what I said to you that day.
This is
what I'm going to say to you on our wedding day. Bobby, you are not only my husband and my half, but you are the best friend and my partner.
Look how thin I am.
The reality is, the only other people that I've ever loved so much and would do anything in the world for were my mom and my dad.
Oops, sorry.
The day I met you, I knew you'd have the same quality they both had. As I told you, from the first kiss, I knew. The best thing that ever happened to me occurred on January 2nd, 2016. That was the day I fell in love with you.
Look at me quoting dates. Like a detective. Oh, Trouble and Jags. Ben.
Remember the day we wanted to kill each other?
That day?
Oh, gentlemen,
no.
Here we are.
Not
today
at all.
We've come together to witness the joining of these two lives. For them, out of the routine of the ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They met each other, they fell in love, and they're finalizing it today with their wedding. And gentlemen, I just want to say, I am so truthfully, truthfully honored to be part of this and to be here for the beginning of both of your dreams and the start of your forever together.
Aww.
Cute.
Neely's so cute.
I think that's cute.
I don't think there's a white flower left in LA.
Nope.
Bobby, you've hit the jackpot. You have found a soulmate, Josh, who's madly in love with you. He will take care of you and protect you, and he will keep you laughing, no matter the hand you two are dealt. I look forward to 100 more years with both of you. I love you guys.
Love you too.
Funny how I never knew that was coming.
What, the hora?
Mm-hmm.
That's because you're a Christian.
We never rehearsed it.
You don't rehearse a hora.
If you're not Jewish, you do.
You just run around in a circle.
It goes on forever.
Josh loves the best of the best, so it's no surprise he made an all-cash
Hillary
offer with quick clothes to land Bobby.
No contingencies.
Bobby, you were one lucky guy and you have a lifetime of laughs to
look
forward
to. Is that
so? Full of love, happiness, health, and of course wealth. To Bobby and Josh, we love you.
Bobby has really, really done something for our family.
Preach, Mama.
Joshy, I've never seen you as happy in my life. And I don't think you've ever been as happy.
Hmm.
Think about the world today. It's upside down. It's off its axis. But Josh and Bobby have found each other. And in doing so, they've given all of us something to think about. Something so positive.
I like this song.
They had a lot of footage from that day.
Amazing.
One of all the lost footages.
I want to see the us walking down the aisle. That was really cool. Or with the flutist people or whatnot.
Bobby, Josh, you know, we talk a lot about rumblings of war and waging war.
Rabbi Barron.
Wait, I thought that was Matt Kornberg. I was like, what?
And we have to wage peace from a place of love. And so we thank both of you today
for giving us the strength and the belief in tomorrow and the hope built on your love for one another, that tomorrow will bring that time of peace.
I know your parents are here with you right now, watching you, and they are very, very proud of you. Bobby, for the first day to our engagement in Paris, every day is an adventure with you, and I love you so much. Thank you for taking a chance on me, Robert.
I love you because you make me proud, because you're adventurous and kind. You are my dream I never dreamed would come true. You are my best friend, my partner in crime, my piggy, my pal, my lobster. You are my everything.
The only thing people took from those vows was chicken parmesan.
Yeah. They didn't even say that.
Yeah, it's
no, they didn't.
Not there.
My mother.
I said one
Josh's
chicken parmesan at a time.
Had such a major influence on him. I'm talking about Grandma Edith. She would have been so happy tonight to be here with Bobby and Josh. So to Bobby and Josh, we drink to you.
Babs.
That would have been cool. I wonder what your grandmother would have said.
She probably would have criticized something.
She said, Josh, I love you, darling. Bobby, let's have coffee.
Yeah. Or she said, Bobby, I love you. Josh, not so much.
That's
these are
not
two
true.
Very different guys from two very different
Maddie.
Grounds,
that was
the same language,
Neil Armstrong. What's his name?
Buzz Aldrin.
That was Buzz Aldrin.
This is Matt.
No, I just saw Buzz Aldrin.
And I encourage you to always remember that today isn't just about celebrating your love, but it's about a promise and a commitment that you're making to each other.
We didn't even get into the cake.
No.
What a waste.
Shame.
Good thing we still have it.
I didn't eat my pasta. Somebody stole my caviar.
We have the cake, though. It's at the hotel.
My mic pack came off of my leg when we were dancing. There's that Hora. Should have rehearsed it.
People still say it's the best wedding they've ever had.
What?
People say it was the best wedding they've ever had.
Well, Princess Diana rivals it.
Maybe even neighbor her.
Oh, playing the drums.
Little drummer.
Bobby and Josh, I wish you a lifetime of happiness. I wish that you both find patience when it's needed the most. I wish that you continue to laugh throughout life together. And I hope that you both always, always remember what tonight felt like. Congratulations. I love you both.
Aww. Now she's getting married.
I know.
Mazel tov. Mazel tov.
That's a lot of confetti. That all ended up on Sunset Boulevard.
I wonder if they get my gospel choir coming out. I can't remember.
That was before.
Came out after Make It Happen, Mariah Carey.
Oh, you're right, actually. It must have been... No, wait. Very
Custard
cute.
Productions.
A fun thing about planning a wedding is that it's not fun because you want to kill your partner the whole way through. And then finally, once you get to the day, you still want to kill him. Well, and then after 2 days, then 2 days after the wedding, you finally start to get happy again.
And
yes,
you can see why you want to kill your partner by planning a wedding. Okay. I didn't want to kill you until you started overriding all of my ideas. It was a joint wedding, right? We were both getting married. It was both of our idea.
No, it was my wedding.
Clearly, she was the bride. I was just the groom who showed up. What did you think of our wedding planner? I loved Michelle.
She's great.
You can tell her you want a monkey at your wedding. She's like, yep, I got that for you. Whatever you want to happen, she'll make happen. Which is dangerous for this one. When he wanted, you know, 60 waiters coming out to what is the song called? Putting on the Ritz? With, you know, everybody having their own customized ice sculpture with 2.5 ounces or 3 ounces of caviar in it. We're going to spend that much money. We're going to spend $60,000 on the on just caviar.
It was more than that.
He's like, yeah. I'm like, okay, well, then I'm going to one-up you. So where we got married in the garden, when all the guests left, they didn't know this because everything was like blacked out from the ballroom. The garden was being transformed into Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. It was very gay. It was very camp. And it was my F you to you.
I don't think it was gay at all. I don't think anybody thought that was a gay wedding.
Pardon?
Yeah, I don't think anybody even knew it was a gay wedding.
Well, there was two men walking down the aisle.
No, there was one man.
I think that's the first clue.
I'm very funny.
Okay.
I'm actually really quick.
And bad, yeah.
Guess what? I have no problem with that.
Yeah, very quick.
No problem with that. Bing, bang, boom. Get in there, get out.
Anyways.
So I don't really get nervous ever when it comes to like going on stage or speaking or going in front of 300 people at a wedding. I don't get nervous. I actually get excited. You know, you have cues when you're walking down the aisle, and I kept wanting to go and they kept holding me back like, no, it's not your time yet. No, it's not your time yet. And then action. That's just how I like it. So then I would go down and then people keep making fun of me because I kept waving at everybody and blowing kisses to everybody like I was Madonna. I don't get nervous. Bobby, on the other hand, is different.
Well, it's a little different because I think it was suiting for you. I think, although it was a beautiful wedding, I think you weren't nervous because it was like your coming out party all over again.
Debutante ball.
When she proposed, it was going to be small and romantic.
Never was going to happen.
Then Godzilla took over. And
no, you just didn't know I was Godzilla to begin with.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So I wasn't nervous either. I didn't want to drink that day because I didn't want to cry.
No, I drank.
Shocker. Right before I was going on, there was a monitor that I can see everybody. And I started choking up, like, for the first time. Like, all day I was fine. Pictures, I was fine. And because my parents weren't able to be there, I think it all hit me at once. It just hit me that they weren't there. They knew they were going to, you know, they knew a wedding was happening. And here I was going to walk down the aisle. I was like, first of all, I'm gay and I'm walking down an aisle. Like, I'm getting married. It's legal. Now it is. And here I am about to do this and walk down the aisle. And I was like, oh my God, I'm going to cry. I'm going to look like that loser. So that was the only thing I was really anxious about until we really got to our first dance. And that's when we were dancing.
What are you talking about? You teared up on the chuppah.
Well, it's saying my vows. That's because I actually wrote mine.
What are you talking about? That doesn't mean I wrote my vows literally 2 months after I met him because I knew I was going to marry him. What the f*** are you talking about? The point that you even just said, like, that I didn't write my vows. That's such bullshit.
Welcome to married life, kids.
No, don't do it. It's the worst decision of your life.
Okay, so we decided to surprise you with some clips
from
Pornhub.
Please.
The vlog team has one more video to show you.
I hope it's two girls, one cup. Almost sounds like the music actually from Two Girls, One Cup.
It does.
Do, 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 do.
We asked him to talk about Josh.
Oh my God, what is this sobby shit?
Oh no, let's hope they weren't honest.
So I remember exactly
God.
When I met Bobby for the first time. Well, first of all, we're Josh's parents. Michael. And we came home on a Friday night.
Oh my gosh, she's telling the real story.
Lots of cars in the driveway. I didn't recognize Josh's car. But there were like three or four other cars. I didn't know who they were. So we walked in the house, and there in the den, Josh and Bobby and about three friends. I think they were friends of Bobby's because I didn't really recognize them. Josh jumped up and introduced us to this tall, gorgeous male.
Who?
Okay, male.
Bobby. And I knew who Bobby was because Josh had been talking to them. And that's first
in the
moment.
Remember? I do remember.
So, I just feel that Josh has been, Bobby has been so amazing for Josh.
It's nice.
Your mom's a very smart woman.
Because Joshy has always been so amazing. And we always wonder, who would it be that could be, end up with Josh? Who would it be?
Is so, it Penny?
That's anyway, Penny the Poodle.
We've found that the two of them are fantastic together. They're just an amazing couple. They have a great partnership. And I really wish for them what we have.
Which is pretty hard to get.
Which is hard to get.
Yeah.
But it's
possible. It's doable.
It is doable. That's what we pray for Bobby and Josh, because we love them both so much.
Aww.
Well,
oh my God!
That Josh was dating Bobby. I was thrilled that he found someone that shares his sense of humor, because Josh has a weird sense of humor, and if he can make Bobby laugh, then I know Josh got his soulmate, and I'm thrilled that they found each other.
Aw, Xander.
Bobby and Josh. Bobby and Josh. What to say about these two crazy people? I would have to say that I am still in shock that it has been almost 2 years since you guys got married, because it feels like just yesterday that we were celebrating you guys in what was one of the most amazing weddings that I think I've ever been to in my life. One of the things that I'm most proud of is the fact that you guys have both put in a tremendous amount of effort and work into navigating the first couple years of marriage. I know that it certainly hasn't been easy, but I think the level of dedication and love that you guys have to each other in the relationship is really what has pulled you through and made you guys stronger in the long run. I know that for me, I am very grateful to be a part of your life, to be a part of your marriage, and just to get to cheer you guys on from the sidelines as one of your friends. And I look forward to celebrating many, many, many more years of your guys' love and dedication to each other. So, cheers to you guys. Love you both.
So cute.
I think when I was about Josh and Bobby coming together, it was when Josh and I were sitting at the local bathhouse getting romantic, as one does. But on a serious note, when I heard about Josh and Bobby, Josh was gushing about how he met this very good-looking, handsome guy, and I thought he was talking about me, and then I realized it was Bobby. And the two of them fight, argue, bicker. Firstly, it's hysterical, but secondly, deep down, they have this incredible love. More importantly, Bobby, you deserve a medal, an Oscar, and you deserve everything for putting up with that lady.
Always loved
love you.
You
guys have become dear friends. We get to spend our summer vacations together. We have incredible memories. We go for dinners and we laugh. And it's just been great getting to know both of you. Love you so much.
Aww.
So cute.
Hi, piggies. I cannot believe it has been almost 2 years since your wedding. I remember when Josh first told me about you, Bobby. He was so happy, and I'd never seen him like that before. And it has been amazing being able to see you two grow as a couple.
She always looks good.
I love all of our adventures we go on together. Hawaii was pretty amazing. I think that was my favorite. Definitely down to go again. And I wish you both nothing but the best and only good times ahead. I don't really have marriage advice for you because I'm not married myself, but
soon.
Just keep the lines of communication open. And remember that you love each other. Love you both.
She's always been smarter than us.
Hey guys.
Reggie Bush.
How did you even get these people's phone numbers?
I was a little curious because I'd never met anyone he dated before. And needless to say, I was not disappointed. Josh is a complete character in all the best possible ways. And what I love the most about him is that you can tell he just wants Bobby to be happy. And that's the best thing you could ever ask for when someone's dating your friend. They're always down for an adventure. They're always doing really cool things and traveling the world together, which I love. It's been really great getting to know both of them, and I just love seeing them as a couple.
Aww.
Hi, Josh and Bobby and Zach. I can't believe it's been almost 2 years since your wedding.
I love him.
It's incredible to see how great you guys are doing together. Josh, I've known you since we were 4 years old, and I've never seen you happier. And Bobby has a very big part in that. And Bobby, it's been such a pleasure getting to know you. I love you guys and here for you always.
Zachary. So cute, you guys.
I feel like it's my funeral, like I'm dying.
So sweet.
Can we get a eulogy video going?
Literally. So cute. Thank you, guys. So...
You know why they did this for the 2 years?
What?
Because they don't have hope we're going to make it a third.
Probably not. I don't either. Very cute.
Well, you probably will eat yourself into a coma.
Very cute. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it. And you know I never say thank you. It's against my religion. Very cute. Oh, my God. That was adorable. Very good, guys.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling.